welcome back to my channel. I definitely will get to my absence and lack of videos lately. That's kind of what this video is going to be about. But I just want to say, I saw today that I'm at like 101 subscribers, but just getting to 100 has been, it's really heartwarming, and I really appreciate it, you guys. I love seeing your comments. I love engaging with you all. So thank you so much for subscribing or just watching any of my videos in general. It means a lot to me, and I hope what I put out there is entertaining and fun, or that you gain something from it. Yeah, thanks guys. That being said, I haven't posted a video in a hot second. The reason behind that is because I finished writing the first draft of my book. This is it. This is my first draft. Anyway, listen to it. It took me almost exactly 1 year to finish that first draft. Now, I'm writing in the fantasy genre, and those tend to be longer word count wise. The typical novel is between 60 to 80,000. You can get away with 50, but generally it's around the 60,000 word count. A fantasy novel, however, is going to be like a minimum of maybe 75,000, but it's not unusual to see 80, 90, 100,000 just because there's more world building and such involved, and that was definitely the case in mine. I just wanted to go through and give you some tips, or at least what worked for me for finishing a first draft, because gosh darn it, I'm so out of practice. I forgot to turn off my fan for filming. Anyways, I have an insane amount of work to do. So it's not like, oh, I finished first draft, everything's fine and dandy. No, I'm going to have to spend, God, who knows how long editing and re-editing and editing and re-editing before I can start seriously reaching out to literary agents, but that's farther down the line. So let's get started. If you want to hear some tips and tricks on how to finish the first draft of your novel, then keep on watching. Make sure if this gives you some sort of insight or helps you at all, then give it a like and subscribe if you want to see more in the future. So when I first started writing, you'll hear a plotter versus a pantser, where a plotter will like write out everything beforehand. They'll have bullet points and lists and world building and characters, and everything's kind of planned out in advance of writing, where a pantser is just gonna fly by the seat of their pants and just kind of go at it. And I definitely just kind of went at it. I had very key scenes or ideas that were very vivid to me, but that maybe took up 5% of my book, and everything else just kind of came to me the more I wrote. The first 3 months, I worked a lot on the first three chapters. Like, I heavily focused on them. I would like write it and then go back and edit and then go back and edit. It was just me constantly editing the work that I already put down, which the majority of that has been scrapped anyway, because so much of your story changes or will kind of expose itself to you the more that you write. And then what you write later on will affect what you already wrote in the beginning. From beginning to end, it's kind of constantly changing. A big thing for me that helped me push my word count along and just my progress along was to just stop editing. It's the kind of thing where it's like, okay, I wrote this chapter, and accepting the fact that this is your first draft. It's not going to be perfect. It's going to be really rough. It's going to change a lot, but just get your ideas out on paper. Even if you read through it and it's like, wow, this is dumb. That's okay. You'll change it later on, you know? Something that also really helped me was thinking about it, like when you do a figure sketch, and you start off where it hardly even looks like a person. It's just a bunch of ovals and swoopy lines, but that helps you put your placement and the movement, and it will eventually turn into something beautiful, but you have to start out with something really, really kind of rough and raw and not perfect, because you need to have that ability to change it. I think it's best to go into your book with that kind of mentality, that these things are gonna change, and this is just rough. My friend quoted some author I don't recognize, so I don't remember this guy's name. I'll try to look it up and list it in the description box below, because gotta give credit where credit is due. He said that the first draft is telling yourself the story, because even if you think you understand who these characters are and where they're going, everything changes once you actually start putting words onto the page. Because even if you think, okay, I just need to go from point A to point B, actually getting from point A to point B is really interesting and can be difficult and challenging, and it could actually end up taking 4 chapters before you get there. You know, it can take longer, it can go down different avenues, different paths. And because it's your first draft, just go for all of them. Just write, let it lead you wherever it needs to lead you. Get experimental, because once the book is done and you have a better idea of what the bigger picture is, then you can kind of look back through and be like, okay, this works, this works, this works. All these things don't work, but you wouldn't know unless you have those things on the page to even work with, if that makes sense. So stop editing yourself. That's for later on. Even if you're writing nonsense like you feel like a third grader could be writing, like boy walked to door, boy said no, you know, just something where it sounds so juvenile, that's okay. It's your first draft. It doesn't need to sound good. The most important thing when doing your first draft should be just finishing your first draft. Get your ideas out on paper. You can worry about making your sentences beautiful way later on. Even right now that I'm kind of going through it, the most important thing for me after finishing my first draft is, does the plot make any sense? Is it any good? Character arcs, kind of really big picture stuff. And then I'll beautify it, make it sound good way later on. I don't need to worry about that yet. I think it's better to start big picture and then focus in each time you go into edit. Another thing that I found to be really useful is have a notepad by you, and if you're writing and you realize, oh, because of this new event, I need to change things from 3 chapters ago, or I need to add this detail for even just the last paragraph ago, write it down in the notebook instead, and then just keep on going. So that way, the idea that came to you is still somewhere on paper, so you don't lose that idea. But then once your draft is finished, you can go back. Your story will change so much the more you write. It really does become its own creature with its own path that it will lead you down. So you really just need to worry about getting your ideas on paper and finishing it. There are so many things where I was like, oh, I need to go add this, I need to go do this, take the time away from moving my story forward and mess with this. And then I realized, oh, that entire storyline or that entire chapter that I thought was so important at the time, I'm gonna scrap it later on because this thing takes precedent. Another big thing is to try to write a little bit every single day. And that is so much easier said than done, because writing, even if you love it, even if you love telling stories and coming up with stories, writing can be awful. Because unlike drawing, where I could listen to music or a podcast or even like hang out and talk to somebody else as I'm drawing, like my brain can multitask better, with writing, you have to focus all of your energy and concentration on it, and it can be really exhausting or just frustrating. But ultimately, to finish your first draft, you have to do it, and you should try to do it daily, not just because of the obvious, like it will keep your work count up, but just to get in the habit. I found that if I broke my writing streak, even if it was just for a weekend, it would make it so hard for me to get back on that writing habit. So then it would go from, oh, I'm just not gonna write for a weekend, to, oh, shoot, it's been 3 weeks and I haven't opened up my document at all. And of course that's going to vary from person to person, but I found for me, it was just, even if it was as little as 300 words, 500 words, I mean, it felt really good, it's some sort of progress, and it keeps that habit up. I did generally have a word count goal of 1,000 words. It's not a crazy amount. Some days I could absolutely hit 2,000 and then that felt really good. Some days I could only hit 500, but 1,000 was just like, that's reasonable, it's attainable, and it's a good enough chunk where things will definitely progress within the story. Not editing as you write keeping some sort of other document or notepad to keep track of ideas that are coming to mind that you can possibly insert later after you finish your book. And just writing every day, making it a priority, trying to keep up that habit, I think are the best ways to finish your draft. And if I could just add one more thing about planning out your novel before beginning. Of course, there are going to be some people where that is what absolutely works for them. That is the only way that they're going to be able to move forward. They need to have everything planned out. But I think that more often than not, at least for me, it would just be more of a time waster because, like I said, your story changes so much as you're actually writing. Scenes and characters will come to mind that you didn't think of 30 seconds before you started typing. And then suddenly you have this brand new situation to deal with. And that's just part of like the creative process. So now that my first draft is done, now I'm focusing more on planning and actually trying to tighten things up. And let me know, you guys, if you want a like kind of part two to this video as to what to do once you're done with your first draft. Because I definitely have been doing some things. I hope you find this video immensely helpful and I will keep you up to date. I hope to hear from you guys and thanks for watching. Have a good one. Bye.